Hello, welcome to People Care Job Interview. My name is George. I'm today's job interviewer. So can you please tell us about yourself and why you are interested in this position?
Okay, I'm a student of University of Longgang and my degree is Master of Business. My major is Financial Management and Human Resource Management so that I have skills and knowledge in these two areas. Therefore, I would like to have a talent management and a human resource position at your company. I am a flexible person with novel ideas and several working experience, so that I believe I can become success in this position. For example, during my study, I'm interested in teamwork, so that I am always enthusiasm in group assessment. And I also have joined in UOW eSports official team. However, this also made me face with several team conflicts, but each conflict had been solved well and every teamworks were perfectly complete. As a result, I have several experience in managing people and making a good relationship between team members, so that this position is suitable for me. What's more, because People Care is a non-for-profit medical insurance company, it aims to satisfy and benefit its members. It also supports a bunch of charities and events every year. And the people carers are always interested in getting involved. Because engaging in charity work or volunteer service is my professional ideal since I am a child. Working in your company can not only realize my ideal, but also contribute to develop my self-satisfaction. I am also committed to providing satisfied customer service and developing novel project ideas in order to make contribution to the organization, so that I'm really interested in this position and I really hope to work in your company.
Okay, well, can you provide an example of where you have built motivation and the cooperation within a team?
Okay. According to my main subject management 930, named Strategic Human Resource Management, there was a series of teamworks during the whole trimester. Teacher randomly assigned members in each team in order to make sure that all team members were unfamiliar with each other. In my team, there were three girls and two boys, and I'm the team leader. Each week, we had to complete more than three tasks, so that this made us feel very nervous and stressful. During the group meeting, most of us were downhearted and discouraged, and I found that our work efficiency was very low. So as a team leader, I had to find a way to encourage and motivate my team members. Then I made a decision that when we finish one task, we can have a break and have some food together. After finishing all the tasks in each week, we can play console game together with boys, and in the weekend, girls can go to Sydney and go shopping together in order to have a relax. Because I was aware that boys can be motivated by playing console game or computer games, and girls can be motivated by shopping and having afternoon tea, all of my team members strongly agreed with my decision. They returned to teamwork refreshed and with objective. There is motivation for them to move forward. In addition, because these motivations, like playing games together, having food together, go shopping together, also helped us build good relationship with each other. From unfamiliar classmates in the beginning, we become good friends in the end, so that our cooperation become better and better. So in this example, I'm able to find different people's needs and make motivation to encourage their work and I'm able to build good relationship between team cooperation as well.
Very good. So have you ever encountered a problem which require you to come up with a particularly creative solution? Please describe the situation and your solution.
Okay. Teamwork often generates problem and conflict. For example, in my last trimester, there was a severe problem happening in one of my main subject management 908 named human resource development. One of the major assessments in this subject was team training session that each team had to build as a training focus group and create several activities aligned with concepts and the theoretical framework, and then shoot the work to other group. Teachers randomly assign team members in each team so that team members were unfamiliar with each other. In my team, there were three girls and one boy, and I was the team leader. However, the boy, he never joined in our group meeting, never listened to our never listened to our feedback, finished only his part without communication, and never helped other team members. However, this was not a simple assessment. The most important thing in this assessment was communication and sharing ideas. As a group leader, I found that this situation would not only influence the relationships between team members, but also negatively affect the quality of work. Therefore, I talked to this boy by face-to-face in a patient way. I was concerned about his study and his pressure. And I also asked him what he would like to do in his leisure time. After communicating with him, I found that he is a very shy boy. With unfamiliar people, and he has little bit social difficulties. But he has many friends in his private life. The most important thing was that he was the only boy in our team, which make him feel uncomfortable, so that he didn't want to join and communicate with us. I realized that during our group work, we focused on completing assessment rather than cultivating relationships with each other. As a result, I had to make a solution to deal with this problem. Firstly, I organized a group meeting and made a phone call to this boy to be sure that he should to he have to attend this meeting, and let them to introduce and know each other again. Then I asked them to have a cup of coffee and talk about their interests and the future dream. Secondly, I gave more advices to him for his work and made care for him after every meeting. After a period of cooperation, he gradually blended in our group, often made some suggestions and joke with us to enliven the learning atmosphere. And finally, we also achieved high distinction in this assessment. So in this example, I show my insight and my ability is to make a creative solution.
Okay, so at last, do you have any question for us?
Yes, I have two questions for your company. The first question is, what is the work objective in this position for the next half year? And another question is that, what are the challenges in this position and what are the main tasks in this position in your company?
They are good questions. This is the end of today's job interviewer. We will keep contact with you. Thank you.
Thank you.